Welcome to another episode of Cooking with Gigi. Today we're going to cook something very basic, very comforting, and an easy staple that you can find in your kitchen cabinet. And if you're liking this video and the previous video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. So today, believe it or not, we're going to cook corned beef Gigi's way. What I have here prepared is my ingredients already: some onions, sweet pepper, garlic. What I did was roast my garlic, and I'm going to put it in closer to the end so that the flavors continue to infuse with the corned beef. Now, everybody cooks corned beef differently. I like to add a lot of different flavors to my corned beef. So here we go. I struggle with opening a corned beef can, and I am actually terrified from it because I got cut years ago. But anyway, if you have a tip that can help me, I am happy to hear it. But here we go. Snap, turn, turn. If I get this, I am lucky, because usually I have to use the electric can opener to open it. So here we go. Looks good so far. Now, corned beef was like a staple in everybody's household growing up. And if you grew up in the 80s, 90s, it was a staple in the house with white rice and corn on the side. Today, I'm gonna just add a little bit more flavor, a little bit more ingredients to it to kind of stretch it and just jazz it up a bit. What I'm gonna use here is a little bit of oil. My oil here is bacon fat. Bacon fat gives a lot of flavor. And so I opt to use this for my corned beef recipe today. So, and I'll put all the ingredients and the measurements in the link below. Then I'm going to add my onions. I'm not going to use all, because coming to the end where it's going to simmer down, I want to add some more raw onions in it so that it can simmer. So I'll leave about a quarter bit of it. I'm gonna let that saute. Yep. And you know I can't cook anything without my thyme, which I have here on the side, and some parsley, which I'll use to garnish in the end. Interestingly enough, I'm going to add carrots. I went ahead and diced up some carrots. Just gonna add, let that cook. And I dice them really into small cubes so they can cook quickly while it's sauteing. You know, you don't want your heat too high. Remember, when you're cooking, you want even cooking. So just make sure that your heat is high enough. Not as it's gonna burn the food. You don't want it burning your food. The next thing I'm going to add is a potato. Now, I do not peel my potatoes. Even when I'm making potato salad, I don't peel it. I'm going to cut this down in cube, and I'm going to add it to this saute mix. So what I'm going to do is cut them in slices like this. And I went ahead and washed my potato very, very good. And this is a white Irish potato that's going to cook very, very quickly. I'm going to do it in small cubes. Now remember when my daughter went off to university, every time she was coming home, she would always put in an order of what she wants to eat. Because when you're in university, and she was all the way in Canada, you don't get home cooked food, or you can't find the basic stuff that you normally get at home. So they come home with an appetite. Corned beef, white rice, and corn was always on her list. Mommy, you have to do that, because that's what I want to eat on Saturday. No problem. Now I ate a lot of this as a child. And so it doesn't bother me. And if I'm going to do it, I'm going to jazz it up. So what I use is just a whole potato, a small one, not too big. Cut it into cubes and just add it to the saute mix. Now, the bacon fat from the oil has given this such an aroma. If you use it, you're never going to go back. Of course, for dietary reason, health reason, your preference, you can use any type of oil you want. I choose to use bacon fat because I want to give this corned beef meal a different take. All right, so I'm going to let that cook a little bit. And while that simmer, another addition I'm going to do today is Johnny cakes. A little history about the Johnny cake. Years ago, now when our forefathers used to, you know, travel to for work to Santo Domingo, as far as Mexico, they would prepare foods that would last a long time, the journey. And Johnny cake was one of those things that they would prepare. Back then, they would call it journey cake. In the Caribbean, there are various different names. In Tortola, BVI, where we're from, it's called the Johnny cake. Again, I will put all the ingredients in the link below. But for me, because I don't measure while I'm cooking, I'm just gonna go ahead. I have 3.5 cups of flour. I'm gonna use half of it to start. I have 1/2 cup of sugar. You can use milk or water. I choose to use water because of, you know, me being allergic to milk. I'm going to add salt. Now for all the flour lovers and the people who love to deal with flour, I am not a flour person, but I work hard to get a Johnny cake recipe down pack, and I'm sharing it with you. So what I do is mix it in, so you get, you know, you get a nice little paste. I'm going to add my baking powder, and this is a rising agent because you want a nice fluffy Johnny cake. I'm gonna add about 2 teaspoons of that, and you must add a bit of fat to give it that moisture. So I'm using regular Crisco. You can use oil or you can use butter. The preference is yours. Just gonna use my spoon here again and take about maybe 1.5 tablespoons. Let me turn my veggies. Now you want to make sure that your potatoes are cooked nice and soft, because you start eating that and it's kind of tough, will kill the whole recipe. Smells so good. Now this could just be a side meal by itself if you wanted to, but we're gonna add our corned beef and jazz it up. All right, so go ahead. I'm gonna go finish mixing the Johnny cake mix. Another alternative with the Johnny cake, some people add is a little bit of cornmeal. You can add that for added texture. I tend to just like my own old school way. And yes, my hands will get dirty because you could tell when you have a good dough when you're feeling the texture with your hands. I'm gonna go ahead and add the rest flour. And you want to keep back a little bit of flour for when you're rolling, so that you have that to keep the dough from sticking together. So this was me showing you how I mix my Johnny cake dough. And you want to put it on the side, let it rest for about 1/2 hour to 1 hour, do something else, come back. You want it to rest, because one of the beauty of dealing with dough, any kind of bread, you want it to rise a little bit so that the texture when cooked, it's nice and fluffy. Okay, so this is my little instruction on this. I went ahead and prepared some earlier so that has rest, and then we'll roll them out. And this is what it looks like. And I can tell you the texture, awesome. So I'll put this on the side here until we finish our corned beef mixture, which is smelling really good. Now, one of the things, as you will know from my first episode, I don't believe in going out and buying a whole lot of stuff. I always think that you can find something in your house to cook. You can jazz it up to your liking and, you know, call it your own take on a gourmet meal. Like I say, today's a holiday. I wanted to do a little bit of comfort food. went in the fridge. This is what I have. This is what I'm gonna cook. So in goes the corned beef. Here we go. Mix it around. There we go. Now, you know corned beef is very salted. That's how they preserve it. So you don't want to add any more salt. What you want to add is fresh herbs and onions and garlic. I'm going to put this on the side so I don't get cut. And I have my handy mitten today so I don't get burned. I'm trying my best these days to use them more. No more kitchen tattoos. On the side with this, because it's a necessity, we're going to do fry plantain. I already have my pan heated, and I'll cut that up just now. So in the comments below, let me know how you like your plantain: overripe, medium, hard, circle, triangle. This is how I like mine, because I like a little thickness to it too. I do not prefer the circle, and I like my plantain just ripe, just enough. My husband and my last son, they want it overripe, and then you have a hard time dealing with that sticking to the pan. I find when it's like this, easier to cook, easier to manage, and the texture is a lot more sweet and delicious, but that's my preference. Put these on the side. Then I'm just going to slice them down. And from each piece that I slice, I get about 4. Now, if you like circles or whatever shape you like, it's your, up to you. It's your planting preference. This is how I like mine. And everybody know you cannot turn your back on plantain when you're frying them, because 1 minute nice golden, you say yes, and then boom, bun up. So the potatoes, I can see from the texture here that the potatoes already started cooking. What I'm going to add now is a little bit of water. Just a little bit, because I don't like it runny. Nice. And if you remember, I said anytime I'm cooking, I have to have some kind of vegetable with my meal. So even if I'm incorporated or having it on the side, it must have some kind of vegetable. So here we have today tomatoes. And all I did was dice up a plum tomato, which I will add. Okay, now my corned beef need a little bit of color, and the color that I'm going to add is going to be paprika, just for the color. Paprika, badia, the best, the best. Let that simmer. And you remember the garlic that I told you? I roasted some garlic earlier. I just popped them in the air fryer for about 10 minutes. I'm going to smooth them out here. Just crush them. And that's going to add a kick of flavor to this recipe. All right. 1 second, let me get my cover, because I want it to cover and simmer down nicely. Yeah, so I'm just going to smush the garlic a bit there. So once you roast your garlic, it actually comes out like butter. Very soft and nice. Now, if you want to opt to just dice up your garlic and add to it, do that. But for me, I like flavor. And roasted garlic is one of the most delicious flavorings. You can even have it with crackers or with bread. Very, very nice. Try it. Don't take my word for it. Don't knock it until you try it. I'm going to let that simmer a bit and get this spoon out of the way. Yes, I'm going to add a little more liquid to it. But once you put that on simmer, yeah, it's going to form its own juices. Plantain. I have my pan over here already heated, and so I'm just going to drop a couple pieces over here. Can't turn your back on the plantain, remember that. It might look nice and golden now, but you blink, they burn up. I don't like burn up plantain. So I got about 6 pieces in there. I'm going to get my napkin, something to put it on, a little bowl, and I'll watch out with a close eye. Okay. Anybody remember from my first episode, ketchup? Ketchup making me sauce. So you can use tomato paste if you like. Ketchup is the way we do it at home. Just gonna add a little more water. Turn on my simmer. If you hear my stove clicking, me and it have a little electrical fight each day, so working on that. Look at that. Lovely. Listen, I like food, and I like to play with food. And I will try and find any little thing in my house, simple staples, simple meats, and just try and turn it into something else different. And just like how I love food, my children love food. My family like food, and they will try. They're always my guinea pigs, so far so good, and they're still alive. Right, so let me just tidy up here a little bit, because we're going to roll out the Johnny cakes. I took out my Sazon because I wanted to add a little bit to the mix, not a whole pack, because it's Sazon, it tastes good, but it still have a little salt content. So I'm just adding it because everything tastes good with Sazon. Everything. Put this on the side. Give it a little more spin. And I'm just having it on simmer because I need those potatoes to cook properly. The carrots, no problem, because carrots could be eaten raw or cooked, whatever your preference is. Now you could have this as a breakfast meal as well with your scrambled egg or boiled eggs. Excellent. And while we're here, let me add some black pepper. Basic ingredient. And as you know already, I love my red pepper flakes because a little heat with everything just makes it taste better. So at this stage while we're simmering, in goes my thyme, because I like to taste the freshness of thyme. I don't like it to lose that taste when it's cooking. So I'm gonna sprinkle that. The parsley is for garnish. I probably have about 3 more minutes left on that pot before I just turn it off and then let it just finish cooking on its own. So far, so good. Plantain still doing its thing over there. And we're going to roll out or Johnny cakes. Need a little more space. Let me just drop this over here. Okay. Grab some flour. Now the shape of the Johnny cake is another thing. People like them square, people like them round. Round is it for me. And what I did, because it raised so nice like bread roll, all I do, I hold a piece, I squeeze it together so I get the ball, and that's my Johnny cake. So see how it's sticking a bit? Remember, we need a little flour. To get flour off your hand, just flour. Use flour again. I should get a rolling pin. That will make it a lot easier. And you can put them how big you want. Important to cut that little hole because what it does, it allows it to cook a little even. You drop a hole in there. That's your Johnny cake. Now the texture of this is very nice because I had it set for a couple hours before I started the episode. Oil is already hot. You don't want it too hot because your Johnny cake will burn and it will defeat the whole purpose. Now, I don't know if you can see that, but it is bubbling. So I learned from my good friend's mom, who is from Guyana, and in Guyana they call them floats, to scoop oil on it. My oil was a little hot, so it's starting to cook, so I'm just gonna turn it. If you scoop oil over a Johnny cake, and I mean, when you're doing a lot, you wouldn't have time to do it, but it floats up nicely. So that's one. Now my pot is very small. I do have a bigger pot, but for this episode, I'm just using a smaller pot to just show you, because we're gonna have that on the side with our corned beef. Sticking up a little bit, but that's fine. You're in your house cooking what you want and being your old chef, so don't worry too much. Probably wondering what happened with this planting on this side. I think it's the burner. So I'm going to move the corned beef. Let that simmer and use a bigger heat. For my plantains. This is my plantain bowl, so I have to keep that close. Ooh, floating up nicely. All right. Do not try this at home. I need a plate. First Johnny cake, all done. All done. Let me grab a plate. Small plate, first Johnny cake. Beautiful. Now you can have that with cheese, hard salami, which is my favorite, or whatever you choose. I just doing this on the side because we'd eat a lot and Johnny cake would be a nice addition to fill the gap. So I'll do two more. Get a little flour. Spread them out. Again, you can make this how thin you want, how thick you want. Some people like to open it up and add stuff in it, tuna, cheese, whatever you want. My mother would be proud that I could do Johnny cake. Because back then he'd be like, Mommy, you can make Johnny cake? Y'all have to learn to make these things. Older generation growing out. So I'm glad that I'm able to make my Johnny cake. And I hope my mom is watching this episode. She will, she's a great supporter. All right. Drop in another one. Do about four of them. Scoop a little hot oil over this. And it's floating up nicely. Like try this. If you're doing Johnny cake on a small scale, just try that floating technique. You're not going to regret it. Like I say, when you're doing it on a large scale, you don't have time for that. I'm just doing a few of them. Put this on the side. I'm gonna wash my hands. One of the downsides of dealing with flour, you have to wash your hands. You have to, because that stuff would stick to your hand like crazy. Put this aside And I'm just gonna clean up this area. Just so I can use it for something else, but later on I'll make sure to take off all the flour. Ooh, Johnny cake is swelling. Look at that. No, I keep using the planting bowl for these Johnny cake, but I mean, beautiful. So it's really only three of us, so somebody will fight for the fourth one. And that's fine. And you can actually freeze that Johnny cake dough and you reuse it again. But when you're reusing it, bring it to room temperature and let it rise. Add a little flour on it just to remove the stickiness and you're good to go again. Okay, these planting taking forever and a day, which is unusual. Like I said, I think I'm having issues with my burner. But they're well on their way to getting a little color. Ain't looking too bad. Just the way I like it. And I'm gonna check the corned beef mixture. Very nice. Very, very nice. Now I can see the potatoes are well cooked. Everything is properly incorporated. The color, the texture, the smell, awesome. And again, you can't cook for people if you're not tasting. So I have to taste. I'll taste piece with a potato. Just make sure it cook. It's hot. It's done. It's delicious. That's Gigi's take on corned beef. I'll plate it out so you see how nice it looks. And what I'm gonna do is serve that with a bit of peas and rice that I have. I'm not doing that now, but I have some peas and rice. I'm gonna plate it together with some plantain and a little bit of greens, and you'll see a complete meal with the Johnny cake on this side. Look how, look at the texture of this Johnny cake. Oh, I'm hungry already. Plantains are nice and brown. Just, this is how I like my plantain. This is how Gina like her plantain. GG, call my whole government name there. So time to take them out. Again, if you have a large family, like I had back in the day, you know, you have to do about four planting. Today I could do one, it's fine. Nice, very nice. I'm gonna put that there. And I am going to move this oil from here because I do not trust this hot oil being so close. So I'm actually going to just put it on the side, smaller frying pan. And remember I said I was going to leave back some of the onion mix because I like the taste of the rawish onion and the crunch while the corned beef simmer. So I always leave back a little bit just to put over it. That's optional. You can have it fully cooked. My option is to have that little rawness and that crunch while it simmer and then mix it around. I think it's safe enough to bring it back on this burner because it's cooked, fully cooked. Now, if you want to use any type of potato, the red bliss potato, sweet potato, you're cooking what you have, you're using what you have, you're the chef in your own kitchen. I had Irish potato, I wasn't going on the road this good holiday Monday, and that works for me. So you can see the rawish onions, and let me tell you, the roasted garlic in this, the different, it hits different. Going to now add my parsley, and this is just for garnish because I like greenery on everything I do. Beautiful. Cover it down, and then I'm going to plate. So give me a few, I'll be back with my plating. Okay, we're all done, and I've plated out my meal, my corned beef meal, Gigi's way. Corned beef with diced potatoes, Irish potatoes, onion, garlic, roasted garlic to be exact, carrots, peppers, the works, my way. And the rice, I told you I had some rice to go with this. It's leftover rice. Rice I cooked yesterday. Peas and rice, plated it with the plantain. This is just some baby greens with tomato and the Johnny cake. Now the texture of this Johnny cake is awesome. I mean, it just springs back with the fork. I'm going to taste it. Don't forget, try the recipe, add your take to it, drop me a comment, let me know how it went. And if you enjoyed this episode of Cooking with Gigi, like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching and see you next time.